I think most Kansas Cityans would be surprised to learn that the sex trafficking of children is a huge business in this city. Kansas City is considered one of the highest hubs for sex trafficking because we have I-35, I-70, Amtrak, the KCI airport, which is centrally located. And they move the girls into here from what's called origination cities. For instance, Wichita's an origination city. And that means a little population of 300,000 is these pimps live there, get the girls, and then move them out. So they don't keep them there necessarily. Girls in every neighborhood, regardless of income, are at risk. If a child has low self-esteem, she's a target. And these guys shop. So if they get an order online for a particular girl and they don't have her, they go shopping. And these girls that are survivors can take you to a mall and they could show you a pimp or a pimp assistant. They'll go, there he is, and that's the girl that he's targeting. Our main character in our film is named Katleya, and her pimp found her in church. He pretended to be a youth pastor. She went to one of these big churches, and she's hearing impaired, and she's a little quiet. And so he made friends with her over months, 5 months' time. And finally, he lured her away from church and put her in a car and had her raped and told her, if you don't do what we say, we're going to kill your little brother. And he held her captive from the time she was 15 to the time she was 23, meaning she had to do what he said for fear of her little brother being killed, and she still lived at home. People think it's just the throwaway kids or just the kids that have run away from home, but all of our children need to be protected and educated about the signs of how a trafficker can lure kids. The women in prostitution now were often once these children, and that's all they know how to do. They're also victims. But if we can stop it at the level of the children, there'll be fewer women that are forced to survive in that way. The film at first was called Children of a Silent World. And as I'm interviewing people, one of the survivors says, that's just so dark. And so I just sent out an email and we had just had a chain, and one of them said, well, what about Hope Road? I go, oh, that's a good idea. So a survivor named the film. I use documentary film as a tool. I'm not a filmmaker, I'm a project manager. So I figure if we can educate millions of people at one time about social injustice issues and really enrage people, it will motivate them to do something.